This video and all content on this channel is performed by a pest control professional, and it is always recommended to hire a pest control pro in your area to perform any pest control in or outside your home. Pesticides can harm you and your loved ones. Anyone who is performing the information in this video is doing so at their own risk. If you decide to try the info provided in this video, please always check with the local laws in your area and read the labels of any product you use. The label is the law. Hey everybody, this is Jason Akers again with Green Acres Pest Control, and today I want to talk about messiness, dirtiness, gross, nasty, what other synonyms could I use? Just gross, nasty, dirty people in general. I want to talk about whether or not they get bed bugs, roaches. Is it true that nasty people or dirty people, lazy people, gross people that don't want to clean up after themselves, are these the people that are more likely, or are these the people that have bed bugs? Are these the people you're getting your bed bug problem from? Cockroaches, is this where they come from? If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. If you really like it, consider subscribing to my channel. So today we're going to talk about dirty people. And by dirty, I'm not talking about cluttered. I'm talking about, you know, garbage. You're taking too long to take out your garbage, maybe slopping stuff in the floor, not cleaning it up after yourself. Let me tell you a story. So I once did a roach clean out. It was, now by clean out, this is basically a service that I provide for my customers where I go in and I do a major, it's a clean out. I'm cleaning out the establishment of roaches, and you know, that's just what I'm doing. I'm going through and I'm just doing as thorough as a possible job to kill as many roaches as I possibly can with one treatment. That's called a clean out service, all right? In fact, your pesticides, when you read your labels of your pesticides, they'll actually have a clean out mix. Like some pesticides will actually say, if you're dealing with German cockroaches, this is how much you use for a clean out service, because it's a major type of an undertaking. So I went in to do the clean out service. I went into the, and they had roaches. I mean, they had a real severe problem with roaches. And the reason that they had hired me is because their son had gone to school, and the school nurse had found a cockroach in the little boy's ear. It had actually laid an egg in his ear, and the egg had hatched, and there were little baby cockroaches in his ear, and he was complaining of an earache. And so they had to go in with saline and wash it out. I mean, he didn't have to go to the hospital or anything. Everything they could do right there at the school. But it caused DSS to get involved. The Child Protective Services came in. They said that if they didn't get rid of their cockroach infestation, they were going to have to remove the child from the house. It was a really bad living situation. So I went in the house, and there were roaches. I mean, it was a serious roach problem. And when I walked into the kitchen, to say my feet stuck to the floor is an understatement. There was so much grime on this floor that you could not see the original color of the linoleum. There were spots in the floor where the dirt and the rocks and the sand and stuff that had been tracked in from outside had just been ground down into the floor so much you could actually see subfloor in some areas of the kitchen all the way through the vinyl, where it just rubbed all the way through the floor from people just walking on it, not cleaning the floor, not sweeping the floor, not mopping the floor. And the roaches were horrible. I was treating the kitchen, and the roaches were just raining down off the ceiling. They were in every crack and crevice. They were coming and just falling on top of me. I was picking them out of my pockets and my shirt and stuff. It was absolutely one of the worst roach-infested houses I've ever been in. And the people were really filthy. They never cleaned up after themselves. If they dropped something on the floor, I don't even think they owned a rag to wipe it up. It was just really, really a gross living situation, and the roaches were really horrible. And this is what a lot of people think of when they think of cockroaches. They think, oh well, I'm not going to get cockroaches because I'm not that person. You know, I'm not going to get bed bugs because I'm not that person. I keep my house clean. I'm not going to be that person, because people believe that synonymous with, you know, dirty people is bugs. And now, I have been in some dirty homes. I've been in some pretty filthy homes in my 30 some years of being in pest control. I've been in some pretty nasty living situations that didn't have roaches. They didn't have bed bugs. They might have had a mouse or a rat get in the house. You know, this is a common thing with houses that, you know, that are filthy like that. are rats and mice. That's the most common problem, because basically the people are living in a dumpster type situation, and that's a rat's favorite place to hang out, is in a dumpster. In fact, when you do rodent control for places like, you know, Olive Garden or you know, Starbucks and even Walmart and Lowe's and stuff, you always treat around the dumpsters. You go and take your bait stations and put them out near the dumpster, because that's the place rats going to be. So if you've got, you know, problems with mess in your house, the one thing you will attract are mice and rats. But what you won't attract are cockroaches and bed bugs. And that's a crazy thing to say. Oh no, they're not actually attracting these bugs. That roaches, German cockroaches especially, they come from somewhere else. So let's say you got Chinese takeout, all right? And the Chinese restaurant you get your takeout from has cockroaches. And you go and you get, you know, a lot of times they'll save those cardboard boxes. Let's say you get a big takeout order. Maybe you get a couple orders of chicken chow mein and maybe some kung pao chicken or something and some beef and broccoli and some egg drop soup. You know, you got the, and they give you that box. It looks like a soy, like a, we call it the soy sauce boxes. And it'll be packed with all their Chinese food. And you take it home and that box has got a couple cockroaches in it. Well, now you got roaches in your kitchen. Okay. So you brought them from the Chinese restaurant. You didn't act, they weren't attracted to your house. They didn't come from somewhere else. They just, they happened to find their way into your house from somewhere else that you had visited. All right. Or maybe you had friends over. Maybe you've got friends and family that have roaches in their home, and they come, they visit, and they bring them and they infest your home with their bug problems. And so this is how you get bed bugs. This is how you get cockroaches. Now, this is not, dirty people. You know, people who don't clean up after themselves as regularly as they should, these people aren't the problem for the roaches or the bed bugs. They didn't come from other dirty, nasty, gross people. You know, that's not how you get roaches. Now, the problem is that these people, if you get roaches in your house, if you're one of these people that doesn't clean as often as you should, clean, you know, you should clean. You should clean your house, your dwelling, your apartment, whatever. Because like I said, it will damage your floors over time. Like I said, the people that were in this one house, they had actually worn through the linoleum into the subfloor, because the problem is that when you track dirt in from outside and the dirt gets underneath your shoes and you walk across your kitchen floor, it creates like a sandpaper type of environment where you're constantly rubbing, and it rubs holes through your linoleum. All right. So that's what had happened in this specific house. All right. You want to sweep that stuff up. You want to try to protect your home. But let's talk about the bugs. What happens if you bring bugs into a house and you haven't taken your garbage out and it's gross, or you haven't washed your dishes and your sink is full of dirty dishes? Maybe you've got some empty boxes of cereal on the table that haven't been thrown away. All right. What this does is it gives harborage. So there's three things you need to eliminate when dealing with a cockroach. If you can eliminate any one of those three things, then you're going to get rid of your cockroach infestation. Food, water, harborage. Okay. You could probably do a fourth, but food and water should really be one. But food, water, a harborage, and heat. You know, heat. They have to have heat to survive. So if you get rid of any one of those things, you can get rid of your roaches. Now, you can't get rid of heat because you have to live in the house. And actually, that won't completely eliminate the cockroaches, because the eggs will stay dormant and they'll wait until you turn the heat back on. Food and water, you have to have to survive. You can't get rid of those. Now, you can limit their access to it, but by keeping things in the refrigerator and putting stuff away, keeping stuff, you know, sealed up and packaging and stuff so the roaches can't get to it. Harborage is places. So that's something that's actually the easiest thing to eliminate, is harborage. So if you do have some empty cereal boxes on the table, or you have, you know, some old dishes that need to be washed, you know, wash the dishes, put them away. Take these harborage areas and these food and water sources away from the cockroaches, so they don't have that as an option. They can't eat the grime on the dishes in the sink, because it's not there. They can't eat the water. They can't drink the water that's been sitting on the table for 3 weeks, because nobody will take and put the cup in the sink, wash it, and put it away. You know, if that's gone and that's not
that's not there, then they don't have that as an option. You don't end up having problems with the roaches getting into that stuff. And so you want to limit that. That's why it's important to clean your house. So it's not that dirty people, you know, cause roach or bed bug problems. It's that dirty people or hoard type mentality where they hoard all kinds of junk, garbage and stuff that they really should probably just throw away. It gives harborage. You know, like with bed bugs, if you've got stuff, if you haven't done your laundry and you just got piles of dirty laundry, maybe you've got a bunch of shoes under the bed. Maybe you just have a bunch of stuff under the bed that you haven't even seen in over 2 or 3 years, but it's just crammed under the bed, covered in dust. You probably ought to get rid of that stuff. You know, that's giving harborage for bed bugs. It's making it more difficult. And if your friends come in and they bring bed bugs, drop them off in your apartment or your home, you're not going to be able to get rid of the bugs as easily. You can. You can. I've done it. I mean, I've gone into these homes where they're, like I said, the lady, I got rid of her roaches. It only took me a couple visits. I got rid of her cockroaches, and she doesn't have any roaches anymore. She still lives in a filthy house, but she doesn't have cockroaches. And the people with bed bugs that hoard, you know, stuff and they cram stuff underneath their bed, I've gotten rid of the bed bugs in these situations. It takes more visits. It costs the customer more money because you're having to do more work. And so ultimately, it's only going to hurt you in the long run by not keeping a clean house. And but it's not going to create the bug problem. You don't actually have a bug problem because you don't clean. It just makes the problem worse. So when you bring these bugs into your home. So hopefully I have kind of squashed the myth that bugs only come from dirty, filthy people, because it's absolutely not true. Like I said, mice and rats maybe, but not roaches, not bed bugs. If you get roaches, if you get bed bugs, and you don't live in a filthy house, that doesn't mean your house is all of a sudden filthy. You know, it doesn't mean that you don't clean. You know, a lot of these people will contact me and they're like, well, I clean though. How come I have bed bugs? I clean. How come I have roaches? Because you brought them in the house. That just like anybody else, even a dirty person has to bring roaches in from somewhere. They have to bring bed bugs in from somewhere. It doesn't mean you're dirty. It doesn't mean you're filthy. It just means you're the taxi service of the day. This is how roaches and bed bugs get into your home. It's how fleas get into your home. You know, just because you have fleas doesn't mean you're dirty. It means, well, they were probably tracked in on your clothing or on your pet. You know, they had to come from somewhere. They didn't just spring up in your house overnight. They came from somewhere else. So hopefully this video has been educational. It has taught you that you're not dirty, you're not filthy, you just have bad luck. So y'all have a great day, great life, wherever you are. I hope that you're enjoying everything. Don't forget, live stream every Thursday night after 9 o'clock. I get on in Eastern time, after 9 o'clock Eastern time. And hopefully I can answer some of your questions. If you have questions about cockroaches or bed bugs or fleas or, you know, anything I've talked about today or anything I talk about ever on my channel, don't hesitate to drop by and ask me a question. I love to answer questions. I love to do my live streams, and it's all candid. It's all off the cuff. Anything you ask, you can ask me anything. You know, I'm there to answer your questions. I've been doing pest control for over 30 years, and I love to share my knowledge with you, my YouTube audience. So, hey, have a great night. Have a great day, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Just enjoy your life, and I will see you next time. Thanks a lot.